Another episode of the House of Talent, and I'm your host once again, OHEMAA SERWAA BRAKATU. Today, the interview is going to be very inspiring, very motivational, and as you all know, that's what the House of Talent is all about. I have with me here a pastor, a father, an apostle, a conference speaker, the founder of the Kingdom Champions International, and a writer too as well. He's here today to give us hope, and he's going to be an inspiration to all of us here, and very motivation. Father, you're welcome.
Thank you, Rahima.
So, Pastor, can you please tell us your name?
I'm called Apostle Rahima Williams, a Ghanaian by birth.
Okay, so since you're here in Italy, were you born here?
No, I was born in Africa. I'm proud to be an African.
So, precisely.
I was born in Kumasi, Osakrom President.
Okay. How old are you, if I may ask?
Very old.
Very old.
Very old. As old as Methuselah.
Okay, so more than 900.
Maybe.
Okay, so first, are you school in Ghana or?
Yeah, I did. I schooled. My primary school was at Wesley College Primary School.
Okay.
And then I bumped into Pokuari School.
Okay.
Sometimes those of you who know WAS. So we call ourselves Akatechi. So if you're watching Akatechi, hi, love you. Yeah, I also did my sixth form at TK, Truma Kodia Secondary School.
Okay.
And then I went to journalism and then I ended up in ministry. So that is that. We'll tell you more when the show continues.
Okay, so Pastor, are you married?
Yeah, I am. I'm married with two kids. My wife is called Vida. My popular name is Mama Bina.
Okay.
And then my first child is called Rima.
Oh, wonderful. Yeah,
and then the youngest is called Amanda. Very sweet. They are all wonderful kids. And they were all born here.
Okay.
Rima is 5, Amanda is 3.
Wonderful. Yeah. So, is your church here in Italy or?
No. For now, I don't have a church.
Okay.
I have been helping churches all over. But now, I'm starting something very unique. It's an intercessory prayer ministry.
Okay.
We call it Kingdom Champions Prayer Ministry.
So, it's not a church.
It's not a church. No.
Oh, okay.
It's not a church. We believe in prayer, we believe in motivation, and we believe in empowering people to become what God has said about them. I love to see people pray. The dynamics of prayer makes the impossible possible. So to me, the Bible says, pray without ceasing.
Yeah.
That is what Kingdom Champions is all about, making the impossible possible for people through the magic of prayer and inspiration. Yep.
So, Pastor, I don't think you've been a pastor since birth. So I think you met God along the way with something. So how did that change happen?
Yeah, my conversion is a unique story. Actually, when I was a kid, I remember in primary school, they used to call me Osofo.
Okay.
And in the Ghana, when somebody's Osofo, it means the pastor.
Yeah.
So I remember very well at P4, when I was in primary 4, friends were calling Osofo. One, because one day I prayed in classroom. You know, the people, we had some visitors, and they asked one of us to pray. And I boldly stood up and I prayed. And after the prayer, all my friends were calling me all sorrowful. That is not the reason why I became a pastor anyway. And after that, you know how sometimes as a teenager and as a young boy in school, friends can, peer pressure will sway you into something else. I was not born a pastor. I became a pastor after becoming born again. Yes, so I was born again some years back. I don't want to go into that.
Yeah, tell me how you met God.
It is something I love reflecting on it. I remember very well. I used to be a disc jockey, a DJ boy, you know. In those days there were no CDs, no iTunes, no YouTube, no DVDs.
Yeah.
What we do is that we do cassette recording. So there used to be a recording studio called Kokomo Studio. And the owner was a friend to one of my uncles. So it was like I was working with them. If you need a song, you come to me. I go to them. I take my cut. But because I love music, and we were, we were blasting everywhere with musical systems. What we did was that I grew up knowing almost every pop artist, R&B artist, and disco boy. I love writing songs for girls.
Why girls
love music.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, so I learned every cool number, the line that reaches there. Name them. We were into that. I was deeply into music and I was deeply into the world. I don't want to talk about how I get into other things, but what I would say that along the line, I remember one friend of mine, who also became a family friend, took me to a prayer meeting.
Okay.
Whilst we go to the prayer meeting, somebody told me that when you go and they call for altar call, don't go. I didn't know what an altar call was. I said, it means you must be receiving Christ.
Okay.
And then when I went there, they did the altar call. And I went. Because the way the man of God preached, the message he preached, it cut my heart into pieces.
Wow.
So although I was told, when they call the altar call, don't go. When they call pray for prayer, people who need prayers, go. Because I wanted to come to Abuja.
So you went for prayers?
I went for prayers. I didn't go for Jesus. I went for prayers. So went there, looking for miracles, not knowing Jesus. So what he said that when they call for prayers, go. When they go for water call, don't go. I was confused. What is water call? I didn't know. Then when I received Christ that day, what was it? I was in 6th form.
Wow.
Now, do you know one thing? What happened? My friends heard that I've received Christ, so I wasn't no more going to disco. When we were no more boozing, I changed. That time I had done wigs, I've dyed half of my hair, doing all sort of things. But I couldn't tell my friends that I had received Christ when I went back to school. So for about 2 weeks, I was playing it safe to please my friends.
Yeah.
But I knew deep within my heart, I have received Christ at home. And then some of my friends would say, Osofo. I said, why do you call Osofo? I'm not. But I knew that something has changed within me. And then one day I said, no, I can't play this game anymore. I got to decide to go the Jesus way. And that was it. I called one of the SU guys in school. The last year of school. I said, listen, I want to join SU. I want to give my life to Christ. I made that decision at home. But when I came back to school, friends were pulling me together. Let's go drink palm wine and all those things. And I went to place, those days were Bitol and Guinness. It's a perfect combination. Mix Bitol with Guinness, my God. Dead room, but I made up bold choice and let me give it to Christ.
Wow.
And ever since that time, I have never turned back. So that is how I got to know Jesus.
Before we move on, I would like to lay a point on that, because it's a problem we, the youth today, are facing very, very much, because sometimes we really want to please our friends.
Peer pressure.
We really want to please our friends, as you were saying, because even when we receive Christ, or we want to do like the Christ, like, or follow Christ as Christians, we try to hide it because we are afraid of what friends will say about us. They'll think we are not, like, you know, how would I put it? We are not of the same level.
I think
it's a problem we need to.
Yes, and let me say this: if you're watching this and you have received Christ, own up, show up, your face, let everybody know you belong to the family of God. It's not a shame, it's a blessing, it's a great privilege.
So Pastor, how would you describe championship?
A champion.
Who is a champion?
A champion is a winner. A champion is a title holder. A champion is somebody who set the goal and goes after the goal and achieves the goal. A champion is a champion. There is no qualms about this one. Anybody who has decided to defy all odds, all negative, you know, negativity around you to go for your dream, is already a champion. You don't have to be crowned a champion before you can be a champion. Once you decided to go for it, you are a champion.
So can anybody become a champion or?
You remind me of my first book. When I wrote my first book, everybody can be a millionaire. I wrote it, everybody can be a champion. The champion is not about fields. It's not about you being the heavyweight title, and then there's only one heavyweight title holder in the world. No. In life, it doesn't matter where you want to go. You can be a champion in that field. If you want to go in the media department, you can be a champion in the media department. You see, photography, videography. If you want to go into whichever field you want to go, the point is pursue a dream. Pursue it. So everybody inspired. Let me tell you a story. Take somebody like Oprah Winfrey. Oprah, as a child, was sexually abused by her own relatives. Abuse, you know, went through verbal abuse, social discrimination.
Yeah.
But today, she's said to be the richest black American in the world. Who is she? We may label her not a Christian, but to me, she has defied all odds. At the age of 14, she got pregnant, not knowing even the father of the child. When carrying this child for 9 good months at the hospital, the child died. How can somebody with such background come out of the mess and become somebody, an iconic figure now? When the 9/11 disaster struck, Bush had to go for her, come and speak inspiration to the whole of America. That is a champion. There are many champions in our lifetime. There are many champions in the Bible days. Joseph was a champion, sold by the brothers. I mean, he was pitted, brought out, sold, went to Potiphar's house, went to prison. Along the line, temptation came his way. He jumped over it, and he came out not just a prime minister, he came out to be a father to Pharaoh, the lord of that household of Pharaoh, and also the ruler of the whole of Egypt, and even the world, because at that time, Egypt was ruling the world.
Yeah.
And he was the one who made sure the whole world was enjoying food because of his divinism. So a champion is anybody who has decided to defy every barrier, break down all borders, go against everything that the enemy will raise against you, and achieve what dream set for yourself.
So I think that's a point, or there's a big gap between moving from zero to hero, because as you give an example about Oprah, I think she didn't, as a child, she didn't think she would get, let's say, where she is today, because I think it's a challenge. It's a challenge because sometimes when we face such problems or situations, we tend to lose even self-esteem.
Yeah.
Because I wouldn't dream big, because if I look at my situation now, say,
I'm a mess.
I can't get there.
Everybody was laughing at her.
I can't.
Pregnant.
Yeah.
14
years.
Come on. It's like,
if she was a guy.
If you're watching, and let's say this, if you're watching this video, and maybe you are pregnant now, maybe society is laughing at you, you feel disadvantaged, you feel less privileged. I want to tell you this, millions of people have been through where you've been. Jump over the fence, jump over the wall, don't allow any barrier to stop you. You can go for the kill, go for the goal. Yes, you can.
Wonderful. Wonderful. As I said earlier on, the show is going to be very inspirational and motivation. If you are doing something, please hold on and listen to Pastor as he gives us hope today. So Pastor, since you're a writer, I would kindly ask you if you can tell us how many books you have, what the books are all about and stuff, because I have one here, Think Better and Get Better. And in fact, I read this book in just 3 days. It's very inspirational. And it's like when I started reading, I didn't even want to drop it because I just wanted to know more and be inspired. So I find this book very, very interesting. And I know you have more of them. So after this, I'll come for another one and start reading that one too. So please tell us how many books you have and what they are about. And if you have any particular book that you really have your heart in.
Okay. I've got about 2 published books.
Oh, right.
But I have about 21 unpublished books.
Okay.
There are books that I've not been published yet. Some of them are on the iPad, some of them are on the PC.
Oh, right.
But for now, my first book was Everybody Can Be a Millionaire. And then the second one
was... So can I also be a millionaire?
Sure. Sure. There's a hidden millionaire in you. Discover your passion, we'll talk about that one later.
Okay.
Discover your passion, your talent, and then market it to the market. And then we'll come up for it. So, and then this one is Think Better and Get Better. My next book is this one called Dream Bigger and Get Bigger.
Wonderful. So, Pastor, can you tell us something about talent? How to discover your talent and stuff? Because especially we, the youth of today, I think we find it very, very difficult to discover our God-given talent. Let me put it that way. And we that we far from home too, we say we travel for money. So when we get here, it's all about working money. And we just put the talent God has hidden into us somewhere.
To me, in my opinion, discovering talent is very easy. Somebody said one thing, that if you wake up, see yourself at the back of a CD cover, it means you are born to be a singer. In other words, talent is about your skill. Talent is about your passion. I don't dream about computers. I don't think about computers. I don't think about electricals. I don't think about cars. I love cars. I love good cars. But I don't think of manufacturing a car. Because that is not where my talent is. So if you want to discover your talent, find out one, your interest. What interests your heart? If let's talk about Oprah again. Oprah ended up in media because when she was a child, it was said that she was a chatterbox, always talking, and it's like, and then she discovered that she could use that talent of talking to talk, to do a talk show, like hot show, like this kind of talent.
Yeah.
And then she developed a dream, and a dream became an inspiration to millions around the world. So if you're a young person and you're watching this thing, one of the ways to discover your talent is to find out what interests your heart. Where do you find yourself, you know, gravitating towards it? Because you can never become what you're ordained to become unless one, you discover your talent. Maybe you're a writer, maybe you're supposed to be in the engineering field, whichever field you find your talents are, in other words, you find your passions are. Go in the early 70s, 2 young guys called Steve Jobs, the late Steve Jobs,
yeah,
and Bill Gates found themselves loving computers. Whenever they are in school, they will leave school, go to where computer labs are. Those days, they were not popular.
Yeah.
But today, through the dream of these 2 guys, they said, we are going to make sure computers become a household item. Those days, it was impossible. How can you? All we know is typewriter.
Yeah.
And their dreams have been manifested now. Everybody all over the world now knows about computers. So if you find yourself loving something with no explanation, to me, that is where your talent is.
Pastor, I know you to be a very inspirational person, very motivational. So I think for now we have to end it here because I know if I should leave you, you're going to make me cry now.
Let me say this before we end the show. There are many people watching us who believe that there is something on the other side of the tunnel. Some also don't believe that what they are going through, there is no hope anyway. I want to tell you, as a pastor, a conference speaker, an apostle, a writer, and a father, I want to say this to you, my viewers. God ordained greatness for you. You have a hidden talent in you. You are a bomb in the making. Great things sometimes come in small packages. When Christ was born, he was born in a manger. But today, he is the savior of mankind. It is not where you are now that really matters. It's where you want to go. So don't let where you are now limit you. Go for your dreams. We'll continue later.
Yeah. You're going to have the part two of it. So for now, we will end it here. And I'll say a very big thank you for honoring this invitation. I've been a blessing. And I hope the viewers out there would also get something out of it. So imagine, that's what the House of Talent is all about. Keep watching for the continuation of this wonderful episode. Thank you.
Wine spinny pon the wine, you not pon the mix, yeah. To the House of Talent TV show. Here we go. I always see you on the TV presenting. Oh yeah, very beautiful and intelligent. So humble, I must say. OHEMAA SERWAA BRAKATU, versatile with smile on the face. House of Talent, what gives me education, talent more and more. House of Talent, what gives me the inspiration to hold on to my dream. OHEMAA SERWAA BRAKATU, House of Talent, everybody one word. OHEMAA SERWAA BRAKATU, House of Talent, everybody one word. We one word, we one word, it's what everybody one word. We one word, we one word, it's what everybody one word. We one word, we one word, it's what everybody one word.